for the record, I mean, in the sense that personally, like, I have met you right very soon after you came out of the FTI, right? Because we worked together in Sambhog Se Sanyas Tak. But for the record, we'll just talk about that period so that somebody understands the circumstances in which you came into the theatre scene in Bombay, what was happening in terms of what you knew at that time, and then we'll move to Chhavildas. So we'll just set it up initially, and then we'll go into Chhavildas, right? So, and wherever possible, use names, dates, whatever you can remember, it doesn't matter, but wherever possible. So just, these are little milestones and pointers for somebody trying to understand. So, would it be correct to say that your first entry into the theatre scene in Bombay was after you passed out the FTI?
After I passed out from FTI, 75 was when I started working in the theatre and in movies simultaneously. 75 October, I think it was, when I met Dubey to ask him to cast me in his play, Sambhog Se Sanyas Tak, and which was had one historical performance at the Gandharva Rang Mandir to a horrified audience of IPTA members. Why IPTA agreed to produce it is another story. And I heard of Chhavildas Theatre. I had heard of it shortly before I actually came to Bombay in 75. In 73 and 74, while I was studying at the Film Institute, is when I first heard of Chhavildas. And I'm trying to recall the first time I ever went there. I think it was to see a performance of Adhya Dhure with Amrish Puri and Bhakti and Amol and Sunila in it, the original production of Dubey's, which I hadn't seen. I had seen his Marathi version with Dr. Lagu in it earlier. And it was a shock to see Chhavildas for the first time because of the way it looked, because of its unkempt appearance, and because it had none of the pizzazz which I associated with theatre, having been a student of Alkazi's and being quite bowled over by the spectacle that Alkazi always liked to create, and at which he was very good. Even while at the NSD, when we were in the middle of grand productions of Tolak and Razia Sultan and so on and so forth, I happened to see the first play, the first time I saw a play by Dubey, and that was Evam Indrajit, in which he himself acted. And I was struck by the starkness of his staging and the austerity almost of the approach to theatre. I preferred Alkazi at that time, I have to say. I was dazzled by Alkazi. Though I identified more with Dubeji, with his crumpled jeans and his ragged chappals. But I thought that Alkazi is the real representative of class in the theatre. I didn't think Dubey was anywhere close. Add to that Alkazi's bias against Dubey, to which there's a long history. But I have to say that when I saw Evam Indrajit, followed by a production of, I think it was Baki Itihas or Suno Janmejaya, I've forgotten, where Puri Sahab played the writer, and followed by the Marathi Adhya Dhure, which completely blew me away. But still I felt that the theatre should be a little more stylish than this. The finish has got to be better, and you can't have raggedy tablecloths and so on. This was my orientation, thanks to Alkazi. And also to the fact that in the school I had been in, we did these annual very grand operas, and I'd seen films of plays by Olivier and so on. So the typical West End kind of theatre, which I have now come to abhor, was my ideal of theatre. I think it was Jaydev Hatangadi, who was a contemporary at NSD, who mentioned to me, it was definitely Jaydev who mentioned the name Chabil Das. And it conjured up not a nice picture, I have to say, to my westernized sort of sensibilities. And he told us that it's a high school and they've been kind enough to give us their auditorium to use. So I imagined a typical auditorium, school auditorium with a little rickety wooden stage and so on. And climbing up those beaten up stairs with the cast iron banisters, I don't know, those steps were always very difficult to maneuver up. And I have to say I was pretty appalled when I saw the place. And I said, hell, this is a theatre? Even more so when I walked in and saw nothing there in the hall where supposedly people performed. They had a stage in one side of the which was never used. The stage was set up with the help of curtains and so on. And I saw my first performance of Amrish Puri and Adhya Dhure over there. Several others after that. I was not enough into Marathi theatre and its dynamism at that time. The only person I knew was Arvind and Sulabha Deshpande. Sulabha because of her great performances and Arvind because I knew of Avishkar, which was then a foundling sort of a company, who always performed at Chabil Das or most of the time. Magic of Chabil Das continued to elude me until I myself finally performed there. It was a place which was hardly conducive to concentrating. There were sounds of the street, there were sounds of vendors coming in, there were sounds of television sets. You could in fact see television sets of the neighbors when you were on stage. There was no air conditioning, there were no comfortable seats. The lighting arrangements were very rudimentary. We were actually performing on the floor with just black curtains forming flats around. But that is where I realized that I learned that ideal conditions are not of paramount importance when you are performing a play. At the same time, I also was able to witness Dubeji rehearsing in various places here and there, wherever he got an opportunity, in lassi shops and in buses traveling and so on, wherever he got a chance. And that is something which I have to say that is what one of the treasures that Chabil Das gave me was to realize that you have to retain your concentration no matter what. And the disturbances in a funny way helped me to be able to keep my energies together while performing. The audiences were always very thin, but they were people who cared. I think we once performed to an audience of 15 or 20 people at Chabil Das. I also attempted productions that I had done in English, and I don't think anything else in English was ever done at Chabil Das, with the exception of Donovan in Hell later, which was done by Dubeji. So for me, Chabil Das gradually became a kind of a tatty little haven which was available to people with no resources, and where people who had no loyal audience could count on a few crazy chaps to turn up and perform there.
Just to interrupt, I mean, from listening to you, you come in from the NSD, the kind of background that you just described, you know, certain grandness, certain scale of production, certain view of theatre, and then in the mid 70s you encounter Dubey because you've already heard of him and you've seen his work. So that's where you work essentially as an actor with him, right? But this next step that you're talking about, where you actually started using Chabil Das itself independently of Dubey, how did that actually happen? I mean, by which time your sort of engagement with theatre in Bombay had changed, obviously. You were not just working as an actor anymore. There was your involvement had got deeper.
I had directed plays a couple of times before I actually came to Bombay. And I never frankly dreamt that I would continue in the theatre. I don't think anybody becomes an actor to serve theatre, you know, or to serve art in any way. We all become actors because we are insecure little people who want to be looked at. And that was the reason I became an actor too. My theatre always gave me a tremendous high, but I always felt that where I'm going to earn my living is movies. I always believed that. And in fact, at the interview for admission to the NSD, I said this and nearly put my foot into my mouth by saying it. But thankfully, they didn't hold it against me. But I always knew that I would not be able to earn my living in the theater. And it was a dispiriting thought. Because the process of theater had always been so enjoyable. I had directed and acted in this production of The Zoo Story, which I then decided to put on, basically because I was just dying to get my teeth into it and to perform it to an audience. And so Chavildas offered its sort of open arms to any such person who was crazy enough to attempt something like this. I did not take myself seriously as a director. I did not think that 35 years hence I would have directed 35 productions. I didn't, and still don't really think of myself as a director. I think of myself as an actor. So my involvement then was really to display my wares. I wanted to be noticed. I wanted to be on the map. I wanted to get employment. So that was really the reason. And Chavildas didn't ask questions. It was there for all of us. Coping with far less than ideal conditions, because that was the first time I'd performed in such conditions in Chavildas. It was a tremendous learning curve for me. Watching the spirit with which Dubeji, of course, and other people who came to Chavildas worked was also eye-opening. And somewhere I think my resolve to continue doing theatre irrespective of what conditions I was met with. Certainly Chavildas is responsible for that, as well as for helping me sharpen my communicative instincts as an actor.
I remember seeing, for instance, Zoo Story that you mentioned there. In fact, in those days, I used to be lighting some of those plays, yes, if you remember. And you know, my contention is that, for instance, Zoo Story was done more than once out there, meaning not just as a single performance, but I think different versions were also attempted, if I remember right. Mm. There was a straight version, mm, and I also remember a version where, when Ketan was involved, there was some barbed wire and we had people walking past, and you know, the whole thing of Jerry and this other guy being in a zoo and the animals, and you know, do you remember?
Yeah,
there was some strange kind of, you know, stuff. So it seems to me that, was it the space or was it the time or what did it actually allow you to do this kind of, you know, crazy experimenting with an idea without worrying too much about whether it's going to work or not?
But naturally, because it cost almost nothing to perform there, you got all the help you needed. You had a few bunch of crazy people around who were willing to chip in anytime you asked them to. It was the kind of scene that did not exist in Delhi, where I was coming from. I don't claim I was very deeply in theatre in Delhi. I was in this cocoon of NSD. But this kind of spirit I hadn't encountered, where you could just ask somebody who was part of another company, I'm doing something, please help me. And they would come along and do it. That was something I had never experienced before. The NSD environment, honestly, wasn't a very healthy one. There was a star system there. There was competitiveness there. There was politics there. It bred a lot of wrong ideas, and that is testified to by the average of the number of NSD students who are actually doing theatre in this city. There's hundreds of them here, but barely four or five are actually doing theatre. And I think that's because of their conditioning into theatre where you do the kind of theatre where someone else gets your costume and someone else puts up the sets and someone else does the lighting and you complain that your costume is not ironed and throw a tantrum. Unfortunately, NSD did that to us. I wouldn't be surprised if it still does. Here was an open environment. Here was, in fact, the empty space come alive, where you could set up the stage as you liked, you could do the seating as you liked, you could perform without fear of losing money or losing face. It was a place where you could make a fool of yourself. It was a place where great creation could happen. It was heaven. For whatever reasons, Chabildas withdrew its support to theatre. I think it's a great loss, to say the obvious. But more than that, it has taken away a space from theatre people in this city, where they could be on an equal platform, where they could be on a common ground, where they could, you know, sort of smell each other. That's the only way I can put it. The resolve to continue doing plays, it was something which constantly astounded me about Dubey and about Avishkar, where they would do plays when hardly anybody would come to watch. And so I have to say, whether I realized it or not at the time, that it affected my a vision of how theatre should be. And Dubey ji's famous statement, ke hum theatre isliye karte hain kyunki hame khujli hoti hai aur jisko khujli hoti ho wo aake dekhe, it has made more and more sense to me over the years.
Apart from Zoo Story, do you remember any other productions that you were part of there?
At yeah, we did some Bhog Se Sanyas there. We did Apratyashit, Dubey ji's second attempt at playwriting. We did Pratibimb. We did Donovan in Hell, Dubey ji's first English production. We did Bali. We did Village Wooing. In fact, Village Wooing was done nowhere else. Dubey ji was that time had quarreled with Prithvi and with NCPA. So he was not performing anywhere else. And then he moved on to the Karnataka Sangh, which is another saga, another space which Dubey ji tried very hard to cultivate and didn't work and still hasn't worked. You still perform at Karnataka Sangh, nobody turns up. And there's a big difference between Karnataka Sangh and Chabildas. Though Karnataka Sangh is a theatre with seats and this and that, but I've never felt the kind of a part of it as one felt in Chabildas. The welcoming arms are not there somehow in Karnataka Sangh.
What was it like to perform for 10 and 15 people? Did it really matter a lot at that time?
To me it mattered, yes. And I could not see how Dubey ji could be so unconcerned about it. And I realize now, having known him for some time, that he was genuinely, I'm sure it must have hurt him somewhere very deeply, that people, but he had learnt to ride it. He had learnt to not let it affect him. And from him is what I've learned, ki 10 log hain. So it was very dispiriting for actors like me who were trying to make their career. But I can see where Dubey ji came from. I can't claim that I have the same Zen-like approach as Dubey ji had. Today, if I perform a play and 10 people turn up, I'm sure I would be shattered. I have not achieved that kind of equanimity with and complete satisfaction of having done the job as Dubey ji had. I really can't imagine how he achieved that state. But then he was one of a kind. And I'd love to know the story of how he discovered Chabildas. I'm sure it's there somewhere on your records.
Yeah, but Chabildas actually, Avishkar was looking for a space. You know, they were desperately looking for a space. And then they got to hear of Chabildas, they met the school management. So actually, Chabildas was Avishkar's yeah, it was essentially for them. And then they discovered that, you know, there is, we have evenings and, you know, we are not that doing that. So why don't we open it out to others who want to share and share it with others? So that was quite a generous decision that the committee at Avishkar took, that no, let's open this space out. And so then they opened it out, and, you know, obviously Dubey was very close to Avishkar. So he knew about it instantly.
Right.
And Dubey was also going through a transition phase because he had lost Walchan, and he was hanging out, he was performing at Teshpal. When I started working with Dubey in 74, we were performing wherever we could find space.
Yeah.
And then he told us about the school where there, you know, where there's a hall. So he was one of the first people with Avishkar to start using the space. It was not his discovery. It was just that when he heard about it, he got enthusiastic. And then once he was in there, then he was really the only, it was the first Hindi language stuff that was happening there.
Right.
Otherwise, it was mostly Marathi. And then after a few years, then other languages, you know, when Chabildas kind of established itself, then English came in, Malayalam came in, you know. So it kind of opened itself out, yeah.
The nature of Chabildas, it just made sense. Dubey's whole being and Chabildas just made sense together. I'd seen the great production of Hayavadan by Dubey in Tejpal when I was a student at NSD with about 50 people. And I broke my heart because it was such a magnificent production. It seemed like the play had been written for these two actors. There was Dubeyji grinning away after the play, completely unconcerned. When I saw Chabildas, I said, this makes sense. Dubeyji in chandeliered surroundings and red carpets does not make sense. This makes complete sense for Dubeyji. And why did it close?
It closed because, you know, every couple of years the committee would change, the managing committee at Chabildas would change, and they had to keep renewing their arrangement with the school to use that space. And for the first several years, they had very sympathetic people on the committee who said, no, of course, this is because the school also recognized that this is an important thing that's happening. But it all quite happened by accident that, you know, after the first few couple of years, because of Chabildas, people started doing theatre, as it invariably happens. You started growing. And then historically also, that was a very interesting phase. But over time, I think the management started getting insecure. They felt that Avishkar has now, you know, this appropriated the space. We'll never be able to throw them out. It'll become theirs. And there were sort of, you know, people who were against our politics of committees, etc. And then they slowly started pushing. So on one hand, that was happening. But on the other hand, the last 2-3 years at Chabildas had also, the work had deteriorated hugely. That energy, which was also part of that time, had kind of got dissipated. So even the work that was happening at Chabildas had kind of started.
Could Dubeyji is not working at Chabildas anymore have had something to do with it?
I think the end...
Because he didn't work at Chabildas the last few years, I think.
Well, yeah, we kind of kept on going back. But then by then, Prithvi had come up, NCP had come up, alternatives had come up, you know. And, it was very different. It was very different to work at a Prithvi after doing a Chabildas.
After,
it was like a 5-star, man, suddenly.
Absolutely.
You know, silence and all that. Yeah. But tell me, did the fact of you actually performing at Chabildas, did it in any sense make you feel connected with a larger theatre fraternity? Do you think that happened?
I felt on the fringes. I felt I'd gotten in. I'd got my toe into the door. That much I did feel. I was in the throes of trying to establish myself as a film actor. And so I have to say that my involvement with theatre was not as consuming as it has become over the years. I was a peripheral player. And I suppose somewhere the thought that I would get work in movies by doing plays never entered my head. But I didn't feel, no, I have to admit, I didn't feel deeply involved in the theatre fraternity. I didn't speak Marathi and understood it very, very little. So I have to say that, no, I didn't feel part of a community. But I did feel that I'm somewhere... I'm in the right company because actors like Amrish and Bhakti Barve and Amol and all who I had hero worshipped when I was a student at NSD. I was now schmoozing with them and actually acting with guys like Amrish and so on. So I have to say I was too inward looking at that time. The larger picture escaped me and kept eluding me until many years later.
Also, do you think perhaps at that time the connect between the kind of cinema that had started, you know, accepting you as an actor and the kind of theatre that was being done in Chabrudha, there were connects between these two things?
Absolutely, because Tendulkar was writing for those movies and he was writing plays. He was very dynamic at that time. There were people like Govind, there were people like Dubeji, there were people like Girish, Agashe,
Sham,
a whole lot of people. And they were all regulars to Chabildas as audience. I have to say that I didn't pay as much heed to the possibilities of the evolution of the theatre we were doing as I did to the kind of movies. And my obsession was with the movies, really, which ended up differently, of course. But I have also, frankly, never been able to find a good enough reason for doing theatre, apart from the fact that I love doing it.
It's a good enough reason.
Yeah, there is no other reason.
Right.
It was the Dubey syndrome. I wish I was as well informed as Dubey was, or people like Girish and Tendulkar were, but I wasn't. So I guess I fulfilled my peripheral role as an actor.
But you know, that was a phase, for instance, when Om started doing theatre, you know. There was, I even remember Neelam,
yes,
you know, getting involved in some stuff. Okay.
Yeah.
So it did seem that a fair number of you who had come out of NSD and were in Bombay, you know, to look for work in cinema, had started actually doing some theatre work. And some of it was done with some intent and some engagement, you know, because it was a lot of fun, but I do remember there was an attempt to do something. Which you don't see much before and you don't see definitely after. So what was it that actually got you guys all working? Because all at the same time.
I think the availability of Chabildas was what did it. If there hadn't been a Chabildas, I would have ended up performing Zoo Story to myself, you know, every night.
Well, you did. Well, one night,
I did. Shishir Sharma won't forget that night. And in fact, I used to do it when I was a student at the Film Institute. I used to perform it to whoever was willing to listen. So it was really the presence of this space that gave us the strength. And had there been no Chabildas, I don't think that places like Prithvi or the NCPA would have fulfilled that same function. They were kind of exclusive to start with. The way you described Prithvi, absolutely, you know, it was like coming into a five-star ambience. I don't think they would have produced the same kind of spirit. I don't think they would have produced the same energy. I don't think that hungry energy which Chabildas experienced any other place possibly could. And surely it has fed the fire in some of us. Because not all those who did start in the theatre continued. I don't know what their reasons were, but somewhere I think I was fortunate because of my association with Dubeji to find a reason apart from displaying my acting to do theatre. And that reason was to get across. I'm not a political person, I'm not an activist, I'm not a guy with any strong beliefs about anything. I don't have anything to say to the world. I am content to act as a spokesman for those who decide to use me as one. And I think I'm a good spokesman. So I think that's a good enough thing. But thanks to Dubeji, I found a reason apart from showing off to do theatre. And certainly the presence of Chabildas and the fact that, hey, there's nobody here to show off to, man. That certainly has helped shape whatever views I have on theatre.
So it's interesting because soon after you guys formed Motley, right?
79.
Right? So it's very soon, I mean, it almost overlaps with the Chabildas period.
Yeah, Chabildas was around very much. We did go to at Chabildas. We also did the lesson at Chabildas. And it was tremendously stimulating that there's a theatre here that we can go to now. Maybe it smells bad and maybe the vada pav you get is not all that great and the TV keeps blaring and so on, but at least there's a place here. Yaar. I remember the very first attempt, I think it preceded Sambhogse's, no, it followed Sambhogse's Sanyas, that first performance. Ratna and I got together and did the lesson. And I just, again, for no other reason except I felt like playing that role. And we got it ready, but we didn't know where to stage it. So we had to beg and plead, and the Alliance Francaise then gave us this space to go. It was, again, it was like Chabildas because it was a hall. There was no stage. There was no lights. There was no nothing. But we just thought, okay, we can pull it off. And we did to a certain extent. But it was not the same energy. It was the space seemed to be working against one. And in Chabildas, there was the complete opposite of that. So, I really don't think I would have, if not for Chabildas, I don't think I would have continued in the theatre. I would have got lost in the world of movies, like a lot of my friends and contemporaries have. It had the smell of the earth, really, that's all that I can say about it.
Yeah, because once you form Motley, then it's very clear that you're committed to something that you're going to be doing.
That
for
we,
a while.
Yeah, and that we want to continue with.
Doing, yeah.
And we thought if Marathi plays can be done here, Hindi plays can be done here, Gujarati plays can be done here, why can't we do an English play? After all, English is as much an Indian language and it's the play which matters. What does it matter, the language? We are getting a theatre literate, 25 theatre literate people who come to watch us and who give us precious feedback is better than performing to 1,000 people who only whistle and clap.
Were you part of Udvas Dharmashala?
I was.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that was done mostly.
That was done there.
Yeah.
In fact, I was a permanent standby on Udvas Dharmashala, Om Puri's production. I hadn't seen Doc Lagu's then. I saw it later. And Om decided to do this. So in one day I played the Vice Chancellor. Whichever actor was missing, I filled in. Om didn't have enough of Chabildas, I think. He went straight to
Prithvi.
Little Theatre, NCPA.
Well, he's now back. He's doing something.
Yes, I'm kind of anxious about it.
Yeah. No, it's very interesting because in this little conversation you can now see very clearly the two things. One is the transition from the big, you know, the big world of theatre of the National School of Drama in Alkazi, and then, you know, being thrust into this completely and interesting because you're open to it because you didn't come with any plans of the theatre. Maybe if you had come to make yourself,
then I might have had a problem.
Yeah.
Or had I been a blind Alkazi devotee, I could see a lot of cracks in Alkazi even then. Many things I didn't like about the man, but I could not deny his genius at staging things. Another thing that Chabildas did to me was that I realized finally why the damned front curtain is an archaic bloody institution. It's nonsense in today's context. What is the big deal of making a big mystery about what you're doing and actors hiding away and nobody appearing and preset of lights and all this kind of stuff, you know. And then the curtain opens and the mystery is finally revealed. And I said, hell, what is this, you know? This ceases to make sense to me entirely. Where Al-Qazi would kick our asses if we so much as peeped in to see how many people there are, you know. And he would say, about, no, don't appear. And after our first scene, I'd go to the back and watch the rest of the play and he'd get crazy mad about it. And this whole word of mystery, the mystery, you have to maintain the mystery of... Chavindas made me realize that the mystery of theatre has nothing to do with any of this. The mystery of theatre is the stimulation that the audience gives. And so why hide away? Why try to disguise the fact that you're in a theater? The audience doesn't need any reminding. All they have to do is look from you to there, you know, and they're reminded they're in a theater. Absolutely. So this whole business of the announcing of a play and Dubeji's little practice of having the nut and nutty come in, and he even wanted it in Dear Liar, if you please, that I enter and Ratna's late, so I look around and I say, kahan gayi thi, you know, all that kind of stuff. It made complete sense, finally, that there is no mystery to it. There is no secret ceremony that's going on here. What we are doing is not sacred. We are actors who have come here to do a play. Welcome, sit down, please be comfortable. Our play is about this and that, and now we are going to start the play. That's the way to do a play, and that's the way, you know, one has gradually been gravitating towards that. Because you could be seen standing in the doorway with your dimmers, you know, going,
craning to see,
craning to see what's going on.